Our project is a creative one. Building on the experience of the teachers involved in a similar project the previous school year and gathering together the expertise of the students who participated then and the enthusiasm of the new class. Our students were, in turn, journalists when they interviewed experts, scientific investigators when they found out the facts about brown bears, researchers when they decided themselves what sources to use and how to use them, artists when they took photographs, filmed and drew, policy advisors when they advocated for the brown bear. I believe that our project displayed an innovative approach. We followed the appreciative inquiry model, which is a way of implementing change, in our case help protect vulnerable species by studying biodiversity, by focusing not on the problems but on the positive. A major role was played by the school library, with all it entails: librarian, tangible resources, virtual resources, community. This is an exciting time in the history of humanity. There is so much potential for libraries as well as for human curiosity. We tried to work closely with the school library in all project phases, helping the librarian to meet the changing needs of the library's members, be they students, teachers, community members. This way, we proved that when the library is at its best, it is a fun and inspiring place, fostering community and civic engagement, empowering citizens of all ages, and promoting literacy. The teachers in my school participated in the project when there was need. There were three levels of teamwork. Primary, as in full-time teamwork, the teachers of English, Art, ICT, Biology. Secondary, as in part-time teamwork, various human resources in the school, the school librarian, the ICT administrator, the head teacher, constant support from him, the deputy head teacher, the parents association with financial assistance. There was also tertiary, as in occasional teamwork, inspectors of English, Art, European cooperation and ICT, experts, regular educational partners of our school such as Astra Library, mass media representatives, parents, grandparents, relatives, friends, guests, etc. Across countries, these levels of collaboration between teachers were duplicated, and I was often, for instance, in touch with the librarian in Medvode. The students worked in groups in their schools, and some of them got in touch through email, instant messaging and calls with their partners from abroad because they were the same age. This was a good opportunity for the Stay Safe Online lesson that year. For many of Earth's creatures, time is running out. Half of the world's plant and animal species will soon be threatened with extinction. The purpose of our biodiversity project is simple: to show what's at stake and to get people to care while there's still time to save them.